Morning, James.
Morning.
Yeah, hello. Welcome to Hits Radio Breakfast. How are you feeling?
Feeling good. Congrats on your new show. Very good.
Thanks, James. So you've got your third album, You, coming out in October. You're a busy guy. You've also got your new single, Treehouse.
I've been putting out, you know, quite a few ballads, and it's nice to do. It's nice to show that I'm not just a balladeer. It's lovely.
Yeah. And what's the song about? There's quite a deep meaning behind it.
I guess so. It's meant to feel lighthearted and just like feel good. But I guess the message behind it is it's okay not to be okay, and just kind of surrender sometimes to your worries and find that happy place. Like, Treehouse is the place in this particular song. That's the concept, but it could be anywhere for you, and it could be doing whatever makes you feel good.
Nice. I like the message. You've also got a tour coming up in October. Can you tell me about that? What can we expect from you?
Well, playing new songs. My hardcore fans who've been coming to the gigs for the last couple of years are probably sick of hearing the same thing. So they'll be excited to know that we'll be playing a good chunk of the new album. And yeah, I'm really excited for that. Rehearsals are underway to kind of get all those dialed in and sounding good.
And tell us about your pre-show. Everyone sort of has a routine before they actually go on stage. What's yours? Do you rev up? Have you got like some big tunes that you put on personally before you get on the stage? What do you do?
We tend to listen to like sort of 90s R&B or like cheesy boy band classics. They kind of get us feeling loose. Some NSYNC, Bye Bye Bye. Kind of get a little out in.
All the classics.
You know. All the classic, you know, boy band ad-libs get whipped out before the show.
Do you and the band do the NSYNC moves before you go on stage? I can't believe that. That's not what I was expecting you to sound, I've got to tell you.
Yeah, the thing is, it's because we go out and we play a rock show, basically. And it's quite heavy. So we just kind of get ourselves loosened up with some cheesy numbers.
I love that. I've been stalking you a little bit on your Instagram. I'm sorry, I'm not ashamed to admit it. And I've seen that you have a custom-made poker table at home. Does this mean that you've got a really good poker face and you're good at lying?
My face, it's one of them. It's kind of got a resting, moody face as it is, so I do pretty well at the poker table. Like, I don't give a lot away. I'm a pretty good poker player.
We've seen, also actually stalking you, I noticed that you've been hanging out with, amongst others, Niall Horan. You guys were hanging out at Diplo's party a couple of months back. Are you and him pretty good mates now?
That was, I've sort of met him briefly a few times, and that was the first time we properly really hung out at that party, and we had a few drinks, and he's a nice lad. Yeah, we had a good night.
I've been dying to ask you all this interview. Now's the time. Your hair is looking amazing. Yeah. It's got good condition, great length. I mean, what are you doing with your hair? What is it? What shampoo are you putting in there? What conditioner are you using in there, James?
I don't know if that's serious or not, because I know it looks...
No, it is. It actually
looks really good.
Well, I am... Because it's been a kind of an off-season for me. It's been like pre-season. I've had a couple of years where I've been in the studio and stuff, so I've kind of thought I'd just grow my hair. And... what am I using? I'm using, I had some highlights put in it, Fleur.
Oh.
So basically I have to use the silver shampoo. Otherwise, when my natural color comes through, it can all start looking a little bit brassy. It's looking a bit brassy under this light. And people think I'm ginger as it is because my beard's pretty red. So I have to be careful. The other day I was at a restaurant and the guy was like, are you that singer? And I was like, it's me. Yeah. And he was like, Ed Sheeran. And I was like, okay,
No.
I was like, okay, yeah, so the hair's looking pretty ginger, and it's all that.
That's the mysteries of every man's beard. There's always ginger in every man's beard. No one can explain why.
I know, it's really weird. Wake up! Let's go! It's Radio Breakfast! It's Radio Breakfast! With Fleur East, Greg, and James. It's Radio Breakfast!